all of a sudden. You see that? I feel bad for the deer.
He keeps coming back. Maybe he smells some food or something. I don't know what's going on. He wanted
I know,
because
who wants to go into the gym and get on that treadmill? Not me.
Yeah, I mean, he's got all the outdoors to do that. I don't know what his deal was. All right, right now we got a lot of clouds, not much rain, but some of us are already seeing a few showers popping up. And we just did have a little rumble of thunder there detected in northern Lake County. So far, the thunderstorms have been in the Gulf Stream where it's been warmest, but we're getting enough support from a disturbance moving in where we got to include at least a mention of thunder this afternoon. There's Lake Catherine with that little thunder shower right overhead. It's going to be passing by just to the north of DeLand. A few showers in the southern Flagler. Here's another one popped up just near the Claremont area and around Oklahoma too. Just some spotty light rain across parts of Lake County. Some more of this light rain back in the Gulf of Mexico, though, will continue to make its way northeastward right across the I-4 corridor on in through the rest of the afternoon. So grab the umbrella. After a very dry, gorgeous day yesterday, we've totally changed the pattern today with this fast-moving fall setup we're in. We've got a disturbance coming through with that chance of rain out there. Low 70s right now, Marion to Lake County around the villages, 80 in Orlando, a little bit warmer to Melbourne, 81 today, but we'll stick the upper 70s out there, Palm Coast, Ocala for you for the rest of the day. Not the best beach day, high rip current threat due to Rafael way out in the Atlantic, also with those showers and clouds around. Not getting a ton of sun at our beaches. Now, hour by hour, we'll plan for those scattered showers right up till sunset. And then even overnight, I'll keep a mention of a stray shower going until this disturbance passes east of us. Then we wake up mainly dry in the morning on Thursday, but then our sea breezes start to merge coming up late Thursday afternoon. So can't rule out a stray shower late on Thursday. And then Friday, here comes another cold front. That'll bring in some much drier air for the weekend, but we do get at least a scattering of showers and storms on Friday before we clear things out just in time for the upcoming weekend. So here's your 7-day. Today, that 30% chance of rain, low 80s. Tonight, upper 60s. And then tomorrow, we'll just call it mainly some clouds, not much rain, but by afternoon, I think at least a chance for a sea breeze shower to crop up. Better rain coverage on Friday before we clear things out for the weekend. Look at those mid-80s and low 60s coming up as we head in through the weekend, Meredith.